It's almost like it isn't even Christianity. It's a different religion. It's a religion called American political Christianity. And the tenets of faith are those espoused by conservative media and politicians. Here in the United States, evangelical is now a political term. It encompasses not only people who take the Bible seriously, but it also encompasses people whose statement of faith is written first by their political ideology, and only a very distant second by the Bible. And if the two come into conflict, they will go with political ideology over the Bible. Grew up with the idea that if, as Christians, we truly believe that the same God who was responsible for the Bible is responsible for this universe, then how could studying those two things possibly be in conflict with each other? Unfortunately, that is not what happened in the Christian community. A day does not go by, literally, without me hearing from people, whether it's on social media, on Facebook, on Twitter, whether it's emails, even some phone calls, handwritten letters, hearing from people who self-identify as Christians in the U.S., but have taken time out of their day to tell me how ignorant I am, how wrong I am, how I am, you know, worst case scenario, a Jezebel, a whore, a handmaiden of the beast, or a high priestess of the antichrist. Unfortunately, we see these political divisions among Catholics and Protestants. When it comes to who's most concerned about climate change, Hispanic Catholics are at the very top of the list. And so people might say, well, of course, that's because Pope Francis cares so much about climate change. He speaks about it frequently. He wrote a whole encyclical back in 2015 talking about how climate change was important. But then you go to the very bottom of the list, who is least concerned about climate change. And right there, you've got white Catholics and white evangelicals neck and neck in terms of people who are least concerned. It has nothing to do with the Pope. It has nothing to do with the Bible. It has everything to do with our political affiliation. Somehow, we've confused our politics with the Bible. I think, really, we are in the situation that Noah was in. The waters are rising, both literally and figuratively, when it comes to climate change. And the question now is, what can we save? And here's the interesting thing. I study this. So I study what's going to happen in the future depending on the choices that we make. And I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt that our choices will make the biggest difference in the world.